Hello, my name is Mollie Landman, and I'm from the Western Pennsylvania Annual Conference, and today I will be sharing a little bit about God's love for us and what it means to be loved by God. So Scripture, the Bible, tells us very clearly and very often that God loves us. There are countless verses, and I'm sure many of us have some of those verses memorized, that talk about God's love for us, how much he values us and how deeply he looks at us. And even one of the most popular verses, John 3:16, starts with the words, "For God so loved the world." So obviously it's apparent that the Bible is very clear that God loves us very much. But in our lives, and I'm sure that I'm not the only one who asks this question, we often ask ourselves, why? You know, why would God love me? Why would a God so powerful, so almighty, so magnificent, so perfect love me? And how can that happen? You know, it's kind of confusing. And I think we ask ourselves this question because the love that is described in the Bible, the way that it is described that God loves us, is not exactly the way we see love in the world. It's kind of contradictory, and that kind of brings up all these questions and makes us a little confused. So, for example, people in this world are very flawed, myself included. You know, I have a lot of things I need to work on. I've made a lot of mistakes in my life. I'm very broken and I'm very messed up and I have a lot of work to do. And there's a lot of people in the world that are like me in that way. So the way that the world kind of loves is all about condition. You know, it's a conditional love. It's all about what the other person does, and that's how we love them. Now, obviously, that's not the right way to be, and it's very clear in the Bible that God wants us to love differently, but unfortunately, that's the way a lot of the world works. So for example, I'm going to bring up an illustration of two best friends and kind of how they love each other. So let's say those best friends are Allie and Rachel. So Allie and Rachel are best friends, and they've known each other for a long time, and they love each other. So Allie loves Rachel because Rachel's super kind to Allie. Rachel always talks highly about Allie to all of her friends. She listens to Allie's problems and gives her advice. She gets Allie really cool presents for her birthday. You know, Rachel's a really good friend, and Allie loves her. But if Rachel were to be different, if Rachel were to be mean to Allie, if Rachel was to spread rumors about Allie and destroy her reputation, or just not be a good friend to Allie, Allie's love for Rachel would most likely change. It would probably lessen, and it might even go away altogether. So that's kind of how the world acts with love. Too often, it's all about condition. But thankfully, and this is the good part, thankfully, God is not like the world. God is not like other people. The love that he has for us is not about condition. It's about being unconditional. And this is because God is not flawed like us. He has never made mistakes. He is perfect and pure and whole. So his love completely reflects that because there are no conditions about it. And since God's love is unconditional, there is nothing that can happen to separate us from that love. So now I'm going to read a passage from Romans. It's chapter 8, verses 37 through 39, and it reads, "For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Jesus Christ our Lord." So in addition to all these things, death and life and the future and the present, all out of all those things, Paul also means that there's nothing that we can do as people to separate ourselves from God. You know, there's no sin that we can make that is too bad, that is too crazy, that is too large, that would separate us from the love of God, because the love of God is not based on condition. It's unconditional. So there's nothing that we can do to separate us. No matter how hard we even try, God loves us no matter what. And that's such a hope that we have as Christians that we can never let go of and that we can always cling on to. And one of the ways that God has shown his enormous and beautiful love for us is the fact that he sacrificed his one and only son to die on the cross so that we can have eternity with God. And God did not sacrifice his son for his own benefit, obviously. He sacrificed it because he loves us so much and he wants the best for us. And he knows the best for us is to spend eternity with him. So that's just one way that God has shown us his enormous and unconditional love. So although it may be hard to understand because God is so much greater than we could ever comprehend and his love is like that, it's so much greater than we could ever comprehend or understand because we can't comprehend God because he's just so wonderful. So although it's hard to understand God's love, I just hope that we can all know that God does love us more than we can ever imagine and that there's nothing that we could ever do to separate us from that love. Thank you.